Implementing in-app purchases in SwiftUI can be challenging due to the complexities involved in managing the StoreKit framework, handling different purchase states and ensuring a seamless user experience across various devices and app states. Furthermore, it requires meticulous management of asynchronous processes and effective error handling. Now, this video provides a thorough guide simplifying these challenges into manageable steps and offering practical solutions. It equips you with the necessary tools and knowledge to successfully integrate in-app purchases into your SwiftUI application. This is part 3 of the tutorial series. Make sure to check out the link in the description for the whole playlist. Now, in this tutorial, we are going to address one comment that Jason made right over here. So I'm just going to read it out loud and you will know what I'm going to show you today. I made myself a SwiftUI app with one in-app purchase, which worked on my end fine, but Apple said it crashed their end and I'm not sure. I bought your StoreKit Pro, but I wish it also contained an example of it working. Now, what does he mean by working? I mean, which variable do I use to make the change? For example, my app has a simple padlock. When you buy the in-app purchase, the padlock disappears, so I need a simple if statement for a stored value. But I can't see where I get this from. Now, with StoreKit Pro, you can kind of do this, and I made it now really, really easy to use. Now, in the kind of the old way of doing this, let me just show you how it would be done. So we would just be listening to the active state of a particular in-app purchase. So this is kind of a subscription for all the changes with the StoreKit Pro view modifier right over here. And whenever the active is being triggered for a particular product, you know, you can check the product's ID right over here. You would change some state variable or published variable inside your environment object. And then you know that, okay, this has been changed. But this is kind of cumbersome, I get it. So I just made it even easier to work with this. So I'm just going to lean in and make kind of an if-else statement for checking product availability. Like, did a user purchase that product? Are you an aspiring iOS developer? Partner with me as your mentor at rebeloper.com/mentoring to fast-track your career. With my extensive industry experience and deep knowledge of iOS development, I offer practical insights, up-to-date industry trends, and efficient coding strategies to help you excel. Elevate your iOS development journey. Join me at rebeloper.com/mentoring. So for that, yeah, I'm going to just take it from the previous lesson, Xcode project. First, we want to go ahead and grab the latest version of StoreKit Pro. So we are going to delete the current library, move to trash, and we are just going to simply drag and drop the new library. This is version 5.2, by the way, just so you know. Let's click on finish right over here. And you will see that we have this nice structure, keychain, source, and use. Go ahead and check it out. The code is really, really interesting. Okay, so as you can see, nothing really breaked. It works as it does in the previous version, but now we have some extra stuff. So for example, if you don't want to listen to these active stages, inactive, and most probably you will not because now I introduced some other parts in the code that you can use. Now, there are other states besides active and inactive that you might want to listen to, but now you can just go ahead and add this StoreKit Pro and then, you know, just use the StoreKit file name and nothing else is required. So products, there we go. It will be just as simple as that. Of course, you may add the consumable info and the non-consumable infos, and optionally the did configure if you want to check out when the StoreKit Pro configured all of these products. But yeah, if you don't want to, you may just leave those out. If you don't have consumable infos or non-renewables, then you can just leave all of those out. So this is the first one. Currently, I'm just going to go with the old version, just so we can see some print statements. And that's our first thing that you can just change in your code. Now, the second one is how we handle now the products when they are purchased. So let's go to the content view. And first of all, we need to make some changes. I know this app storage was really, really convenient with the coins and the weekly. And then we just needed to convert the non-renewable expiration date string. It was kind of cumbersome, so I made it easier. Instead of using all of these app storage, we are going to move away from this model. Therefore, I'm just going to simply remove both of them. And also, this is non-renewable active is no longer needed. Let's talk about the coins, because those are kind of related to a doubles, like an amount. Otherwise, all of the other ones are related to a certain date when it will be expired. Even non-consumables, they have a nil value for their expiration date. So let's create a state variable, state private var coins. It will be a double and equals to 0.0. Okay, so this is basically how you just going to update the coin value on your views. Now, how would we access those coins? Well, we want to make sure actually that we, and I'm just going to remove this section so we don't have any warnings over there. And the section about coins is all right. And this one, you know, we are no longer listening to this. And on appear, we are not going to grab the non-renewable information. Okay, so we just cleaned up our project. What we want to know when the IDs, when we have configured all of our IDs. Now, you could just move the isConfigure state variable, but that's kind of cumbersome. What we want to know is when are the IDs ready? And when they are, we want to fetch the coins. So we're just going to listen with an onReceive of the StoreKit pros dot dollar sign IDs. So when the IDs are ready, basically, we are going to get the IDs, but we don't really care about the array of IDs. We want to grab the coins. So self.coins equals StoreKit pro. On StoreKit Pro dot, and here is the new function that I added, and that is the product result for ID. As you can see, we need an ID. Now the ID is in our case products dot coin, okay, and we are going to get back a product result. Now this product result has some nice properties on it, meaning the amount, the expiration date, the actual ID, if you want to reuse it, and is it active? Now, in this case, this particular case, we want the amount. All of them, by the way, are optional besides the is active that is just true or false. Now, the amount is, as you can see, an optional double. So we're just going to set it up for the coins and give it a default value if we are not going to get, if there is going to be a nil value for the amount. Because there might be, of course, you know, in an auto-renewable subscription, that amount will get you a nil value. But of course, you're not going to use that over there. You are going to use this right over here. So yeah, that's how you are going to grab your coins. Now, how to consume the coins? Because now you can see that we are consuming just like this. You basically want to update now the coins state variable. If you don't want to, you may just continue using the regular one with the consume an amount for the product ID. But and let me just duplicate this and remove that. You can have now binding for those coins. So we just have a count right over here. You can see it's a binding of a double, and you're just going to say dollar sign and coins. So just binding the actual value for that count. Let me just see what's going on. Yes, you want to now have this as a main actor. Okay, so and what's wrong with, okay, it's no asynchronous right now. Just fix all of those. Great. And It's as simple as that. I'm going to leave the task right over here, or rather, let me just move this out and make this example really straightforward. So it's outside of the task where I'm going to have a do catch statement. There we go. Let's print out the errors, localized description, and just paste it in there. Okay, so yeah, that's a new way of doing it if you want to link it to some sort of a state variable. Okay, that's consumables, but there are others too. So let me just go through basically all of them. So it will be really, really fun. So after the coin section, I'm going to create a new one. So section, and we're going to name this products. And we are going to go through, well, just like this. I added those two parentheses a little bit earlier. So we are going to go with a for each, and then StoreKit pro.ids. I'm going to go through all of the IDs, but you can just use this individually one by one if you choose to. ID will be self.self, okay, that's string actually, and then we are going to get back an ID in. Okay, so I just want to create this if else statement, you know, a view that shows something if the ID is, well, the in-app purchase is inactive, and something else if it's active. Basically, we're going to give access. So we have this new StoreKit Pro view. So StoreKit Pro view. And we have this IDs. That's an array of strings, and it could be just one. And then the active and the inactive view. So for the IDs, I'm just going to go here with one ID because we are just going to go for ID. I'm just going to show you when we have an array also. And then the active and the inactive state. Now, I'm just going to go with a simple text for this particular example. And we would say ID. Well, let's just have those quotes also. ID is active. And then let's duplicate this, move it down, and say ID is inactive. Now, you could just, of course, change this to whatever you'd like. Let's build and run and see how this looks like. Okay, so here we are. We have this ID is active for the lifetime. And if you remember in the previous episodes, we bought that. Now, the weekly is inactive because, you know, it just expired. The monthly is active and the yearly is inactive. So you can just, this is kind of our if-else statement. But wait, there is a more. We see we have this monthly inactive, monthly active, and the yearly is inactive. But basically, it's the same membership. How would we change that? Well, we can do that by adding multiple IDs. So let's create another section. Let's see this. Section membership. So right over here, we need basically two IDs. So let's just add that to the StoreKit Pro view, StoreKit Pro view. And the IDs, it's basically an array, but this is, you may add one at a time. So we're just going to have them have added as product.com. Monthly, and the order is not really important. So, well, not important at all. We are just going to have yearly right over there. And then for the active one, let's just have a simple access membership, access membership view, which I'm going to create right over here, membership. Let's just scroll down. Let's have a function of access membership view, sum view. Okay, well, let's just return the text for now. So we're not going to have any errors. Okay, let's scroll up. And for the inactive, well, I'm just going to go with an empty view right now. So you could just also eliminate the inactive kind of button right over here that we are going to have. Or you could just say, okay, your membership is inactive. You can go to the store and purchase it. Even have a button or a navigation link to that store. So now let's have that navigation link for the membership. It's basically whenever the membership is active, we are just going to have a navigation link. Let's use the one with the destination and label. Well, I'm just going to go text membership. And then for the label, I'm going to say access the membership. So let's see it right now. Let's just scroll all the way up. Either the monthly or the yearly is going to be purchased. We are going to have this access membership button. This is the active view that we added. It's as simple as that. And now, finally, I'm going to show you how you can have a more detailed info about all of these products. Now, with this, it's just going to be a little bit imperative. You know, all of these views that I have created, they are really declarative. You can just put them on the view. And we kind of used it right over here on the product result when we access the coins. Let me just show you how you can do this for all the other products. So we are going to have a section, another section right over here for product result. There we go. And in the product result, I'm going to go through all of the IDs. So let me just go with for each, and then StoreKit Pro.IDs, and then the ID will be self. Oh, I need a comma right over here, comma ID.self. And we are going to get the ID in. There we go. And right over here, I'm just going to have a simple button so we can read that product result. So let's have a button with a title of ID, that's fine. And then the action, we're going to get a result. Result equals, and then StoreKit Pro dot product result for the ID of ID. And currently I'm just going to print it out so we can see all of the information on that result. So I'm just going to print out the result. Let's build and run and see what we are going to be printed out when we tap on any of these. So you can see here we have our products lifetime, and we have is active true, the ID, and the expiration date is of course nil because this is a lifetime one, and amount is nil because we don't have any on these store, you know, all of the amounts. Now for the coin, that would be interesting because we need to have four. It should be four, as you can see right over here. Let me just see if I just click on this. There we go. It's active, of course, because we have purchased. ID, expiration date nil, amount four. Now let's go to the weekly. It is active, false. And of course, the we have previously purchased, so the expiration date is this one on the 8th, which is, it has been passed really. And then we have the monthly, is active true, expiration date it's the 30th, and the amount of course is nil. Now let's take a look at the yearly too. Is active false. And then expiration date nil, and amount nil, of course, because we did not purchase the yearly subscription. Now, this is how you would just have all of this information and just do some certain things inside your app with this information. And otherwise, just use the views that I added, StoreKit Pro View, and also calculate the coins from that consumable product results amount. Now, if you like this, go ahead and check it out. It's at StoreKit Pro, store.rebeloper.com/StoreKit Pro. The link for a 50% off, it's still valid, is in the description down below.